Today I'm supposed to go to Houston, but I'm really scared because I don't know if this is the right thing for me to do, and I'm not ready for this. You know, Sandy wants me to go now, but I keep talking to Denise about it, and she thinks I should stay here because of my condition and how hard it's going to be for me to travel. But Sandy has a truck here to move me, and she said she talked to Dr. Nell to make sure an ambulance was coming today. So I don't know what to do, because I'm not ready.
How you doing, ma'am? We're going to take you to your other house, okay? Is that all right?
It's news to me.
Do you want to go over there?
I'm not prepared.
What's going on, Cindy?
I don't know. I've already said everything else needs to be gathered and everything situated. I've told y'all over and over again. I'm not being listened to. It's just being forced upon me, not even giving me the option. Like, yes,
we're
united.
They're pressuring you, man, because they're trying to save your life. We're trying to save your life and get you in a better position.
Do you think you're going to get a notice for death? What if you die?
I don't know how much longer this I can take.
No, Cindy. I just took you a bath, and you had a long time to think about it in the shower. Are we going to Houston? All you gotta do is sit on that stretcher, hop on it, and it'll be your new life.
I took a shower, but I don't feel any different. If anything, I'm more annoyed because Sandy keeps asking the same thing over and over. And it's just making me feel like staying because it's kind of rude.
So you're just gonna sit here and die? You're already right here.
I don't know, I have to make some calls.
Are you serious? You're right here. On the edge, you can just walk to the stretcher, sit down, and they'll lay you down.
Cindy, what are you doing? What are we gonna do? You know what you wanna do. You know if you wanna go or not.
There you go.
Where am I going right now?
You're gonna go to my house.
We don't have the bed yet.
We do have the y'all the bed.
Yes, we do have the
Everything's
bed.
Everything's taken care of.
Everything is taken care of, Cindy.
Let me see it.
You already know that it's taken care of. We have everything for you. You're just making excuses again.
We can't stay here all night. You have to give us a decision.
Just say yes or no.
Then it's no.
I don't even know what to do anymore. I'm begging you and, you know, offering. You're just gonna make me cry. Oh, God.
I said, because I'm gonna think about it. I said, let me make the calls to see what I decide.
Gosh. Okay, Cindy. I can't leave. I need you to tell me, are you gonna go or not? Because
I guess I'm gonna go.
What? Oh my God. We're gonna go then.
Yes.
Yes.
I wanted to go the whole time. I'm just still pretty angry that Sandy was so stubborn about how she forced me to do it her way.
I'll grab all that, okay?
But I don't want to mess up my life any more than I already have.
I'll help you up, okay? You count down to three, okay?
Just don't.
One, two, three. Okay.
So I had to say yes. I'm just so nervous, though. And it makes me more mad that we have to do it this way.
Cindy finally agreed to go to Houston with me. Her life truly depends on this. But you know, she's been talking to her old caretakers throughout the day.
Her caregivers were not supportive. They were only thinking of themselves, you know, money or if they could get something for Christmas for their children. Somebody like Cindy, she needs somebody that really, really loves her, that cares enough to take her under their wing. And she didn't have that, you know?
Thankfully, we have made it to Houston, and we are going to try to get Cindy into my house and get her settled. I have a special chair that we have set up for her that I need to get her to. And once she gets situated and she's able to rest for a bit, hopefully she'll feel a lot better and get more positive. But right now, I know she's upset.
Oh God.
Welcome, Cindy. Mi casa es tu casa.
Oh, sorry. There you go.
Where's the bed?
It's coming.
Not too low.
I'm glad that trip and the whole battle to get Cindy here is over, but all the way here, she kept changing her mind and wanting to go home.
One, two,
three. Okay.
Right. And it's just been a mess because every time we try to speak to her, she was talking to the other caretaker. The other caretaker was giving her negative text messages, trying to convince Cindy this is bad for her. So it was almost like if they're trying to hold her hostage in her own home, you know?
Okay, hold on. Don't pull me straight up. Don't pull straight up. Stop!
The whole situation today was completely insane. One earplug with her friend in it, and me right here in front of her. We could not get anything through to the end. That's not a very loving caregiver.
Is this all I've done?
I really think she deserves a second chance. I really do. And now that she's here with me, I'm going to take care of her. And my daughter Candy is going to help take care of her too, so I feel like she's got a new start in life.